Hello everyone and welcome to the top 10 heart characters on Bleach Brave Souls. Now I've said this before, but it's never been more true. There are a ton of good heart characters. In fact, I could actually make this a top 20, but that would take me 8 hours and I barely have enough time as it is. Before I begin, please note that for the sake of not having to deal with it, I am excluding the Senkaimon version of Zangetsu on this list, simply because he's available in every attribute, so he's not really an exclusive character. Senkaimon Aizen will also be excluded, but let's be real, he was never gonna make the list anyway. And now that that's out of the way, let's begin. Now starting off the list at number 10 is the Can't Fear Your Own World version of Grimmjow, a character that, I'm not gonna lie, I was a bit disappointed with. Not as much as some other people who really liked the character, but still a little bit sad. Nevertheless, he's still a remarkable character with a really high SP as well as Frenzy, and regardless of how you feel about him, he's a really good character. He's one of the few that has the ability to inflict Lacerate on all of his attacks, and his strong attack 3 is a charge move that when fully charged basically doubles his strength. Sadly, it doesn't have the best range. This is very unfortunate, but it's pretty typical among charge moved characters. Now this would be a bit more forgiving if his other strong attacks had good range, but unfortunately they don't. It's decent, but not great. But like I said earlier, they do inflict Lacerate, and that's a pretty big deal. Not only does it do consistent damage, but it also prevents the opponents from using any strong attacks or special moves. Granted, this only affects bosses, but it is incredibly valuable in things like Senkaimon, since it can give you some valuable extra moments. On top of all this, Grimmjow is also completely immune to being burned. So yeah, he may not be the Grimmjow that we wanted, but he's definitely still a good character. Now at number 9 we have the most recent version of Isshin Kurosaki, who not only has a really high SP and frenzy, but also ridiculous range on his strong attacks. Strong attack 3 being full screen, and his strong attacks 1 and 2 basically obliterating everything in front of him for like a mile. Seriously, dude's got crazy range. He can also inflict debilitating burn on all of his attacks, which is, you know, always a plus. Isshin's also very fast at attacking, not only with his strong attacks, but also with his normal attack. Granted, it doesn't deal as much damage, but it can also inflict the burn. Finally, we have his soul trait, which is Last Ditch Survival. While it didn't always used to be good, it now allows characters to come back from the dead if they were to die. This, combined with his speed and range, make him a fairly decent option for autoing, since if he gets killed by the boss, he can always come back and unleash his strong attacks again. I really wasn't expecting another Isshin since the last one we got before this was also pretty good, but I'm not gonna lie, it was a pretty good surprise. Next on the list is the Bonds version of Uryu, who, like the other two, also has a really high SP and frenzy. Uryu can inflict debilitating burn on all of his strong attacks, which, by the way, are all pretty good. Strong attack 1 pushes enemies back while hitting multiple times, and his strong attack 2 is a crawling vortex move, which is good for racking up the combo, pushing enemies back, and inflicting the debilitating burn. A set like this isn't really good for speed, but it is really good for crowd control, not to mention high points on guild quests. And then there's his strong attack 3 that's a charge move. Much like Grimmjow's, it's also not full screen, but unlike Grimmjow's, this move hits enemies all around Uryu, instead of directly in front of him. Combine these strong attacks with a strong attack recharge link, and you have a character that can not only control the field for most of the game, but also consistently deal damage in burn and actual attacks. Then there's the fact that he's also a human, so he doesn't really have many weaknesses. You're safe to take him in any inherited zone or droplet zone, at least for now, as long as they have Arrancar enemies anyway. Coming in at number 7 is the Captain of Squad 10, the Bonds version of Toshiro Hitsugaya, who has a really high SP of 782, and as you may have guessed, also Frenzy. In addition to this, he's also got a plus 25 full stamina damage link, meaning that as long as he's at full health, he will deal 25% more damage across the board, including strong attacks, normal attacks, and his special. Now obviously this is kind of a double-edged soul trait. After all, if you take even 1 point of damage, you're basically left soul traitless. But K-Lab is getting smarter about who they give this link to, and they did equip Toshiro with some abilities to help with this. For one, he starts off with 10 barriers. In addition to this, his strong attack 2 is also a barrier move that can keep giving him barriers during the duration of the mission. This also makes him a really good support character since he can give barriers to the rest of the team. This strong attack is also the only one of his moves that cannot inflict debilitating freeze, as the rest of them can. They also have really good range, including the strong attack 3 that's a full screen, so he's pretty well covered. All of this make him a really good PvE character and a pretty decent PvP character, since he starts off with 10 barriers, and you can easily build him as a glass cannon character. It's not exactly effective against characters like Noritora with their own barriers, but you know, pick your battles. Coming in at number 6, we have the Parasol version of Halibel, who has a whopping 786 SP and also Frenzy. She can also inflict debilitating weakening on all of her attacks, and she's very likely to do so, thanks to what her strong attacks actually are. Her strong attack 1 is a pushback move that hits a large number of times, and her strong attack 2 is a crawling vortex move. As I mentioned earlier with Uryu, it's good for a variety of different things. But unlike Uryu's, hers can inflict weakening, which is actually even better, because with this you can inflict it easily on a boss right before they use their special, a tactic I often use in Senkaimon. After this is her strong attack 3 that's a full screen. She honestly has a good setup for crowd control, and she's able to deal a lot of damage thanks to her high SP and the weakening. Not to mention she's also completely immune to being frozen, and her normal attack, while not dealing that much damage, is piercing, and also has a pretty good chance of inflicting weakening. Honestly, she's just a well-rounded, really strong character. She doesn't have any particular gimmick, she's just really good. Okay, from 10 to 6 they were really good characters, but from here on out they just become monstrous. We start off with the actual monster, Yami, at number 5. Now not only does he have a really high attack, but he's also got flurry and poise. And while this in itself isn't very rare these days, Yami actually has a hollow killer, which is a pretty big deal, considering most characters with flurry and poise are typically given espadas or captain killers. And having a really good killer like this will mean that you're extra effective in things like Senkaimon, inheritance zones, and droplet zones where killers are multiplied. Yami also has a 20% nadling, so his attacks are gonna deal even more damage. Though I should point out that his normal attack string isn't as long as some other characters. Still, his normal attacks aren't the only useful things he has, as he also has debilitating burn on all of his strong attacks. They'd all have pretty good range. In addition to this, he's also completely immune to being frozen. All of this make him a really good character for PvE, and one of the best characters to auto with. You can also take him in PvP, though in that particular case his killer isn't as good. And then there's also his attack string.
Bankai. Minazuki. Zakkyō wa kore ni te oshimai.
Now at number 4 on the list we have Retsu Unohana, or I guess in this particular case Yachiru Unohana, which honestly might be the highest she's ever been on a list. Not saying a lot, she's well over a year and a half old, but she still holds up extremely well, having not only a really high attack but also flurry and poise. In addition to this, she's also got a 16% damage reduction link that can be stacked up to 76%, and her strong attack 2 is a heal move, making her really, really hard to kill. Granted, Caleb has found a few ways to make her not as unkillable in PvP, but she definitely still holds up there. In PvE, however, she continues to be unbelievably reliable, and one of the best attack units and support units in the game. As I mentioned, her strong attack 2 is a heal move, but it's not the only thing she has, as her special also heals the entire team for 60%, and has a chance to instant kill the enemies. This makes her really useful in co-op, and extremely useful just about everywhere else. She may not sit on top on PvP anymore, but there's no question that she's still one of the best characters in the entire game. At number 3 we have the Thousand Year Blood War version of Ichigo, more specifically the Bankai one, who has a really high SP as well as Frenzy, and one of the most versatile movesets in the whole game. Strong Attack 1 and Strong Attack 3 have decent range, with his Strong Attack 3 being full screen, and his Strong Attack 2 is a boost move. But unlike most boost moves, it doesn't just increase the entire team's attack, defense, and focus by 33%. It also transforms Ichigo and increases his magnifications. His strong attacks go from a 120 mag to a 140 mag, and his normal attack get an increase in magnifications as well, not to mention that 33% increase in attack. Meaning that if you wanted to, you can actually build him with a normal attack damage build, and he would actually do pretty well. Now other specials such as Manga Kenny, Manga Yoroichi, and the speed version of Shinji also have a similar effect. However, for them you have to use their special and it only lasts for 30 seconds. Ichigo on the other hand has this for his strong attack too. He has Enhancer so it only lasts 20 seconds, but thanks to his strong attack recharge link, you can actually stay in this form indefinitely if you build him correctly. This would also boost the entire team indefinitely, and this makes him a great support character as well as attacker. Finally, we have the fact that he's completely immune to being paralyzed and weakened. This and his abilities mean that if you wanted to, you could also make him a really good autoer. And it's his versatility that puts him so high up on this list. Now these last two were unbelievably difficult to place. They're both extremely good characters and very different characters. And I know whichever way I did it, I was gonna take a lot of heat, but I live in Texas and I drive a car with no AC, I can take the heat. And I decided to put Soifun at number 2. Not only does she have a really high attack of 767, but she's also got a plus 20 NAD link, as well as poise and flurry. In addition to this, she's also got an Arrancar killer, making her extremely effective anywhere Arrancars are the enemies. And unlike Yami, who also has a good killer, she's actually got a decent NAD string. Now if it was just this, she'd be a really powerful character. But she's also got a strong attack too that's a boost move with Enhancer, making her even more powerful. And much like Ichigo before her, her boost move also changes her magnifications, making her normal attack even more effective and now with an attack that's over 1000. Now the magnifications on the strong attacks also change. It's actually greater than the magnifications on normal attacks, meaning that while the boost moves are technically the same for her and Ichigo, he gets more out of it than she does, at least as far as mags are concerned. In addition to being a boost move, her strong attack 2 is also a vortex move that surrounds her. It may not deal that much damage, but it does stagger the enemies, and almost doubles as a shield for her, helping protect her from damage, and being pretty useful against bosses. Finally, because she's a Soifun, she's also got extended flash steps. In my opinion, they should have given her long stride, but this is still really good for getting around, and it comes in handy when dodging specials. Now before I get to number 1, here are a few honorable mentions.
ことないから特別に言ってあげても化けだからね見れば分かるでしょ私の気持ち受け取るわね春神と呼ばれたわしの動き、お主に見切れるかのどうじゃ地獄から逃げられるのはただ一人このスズムシ本体を握る者だけだ
Nuggets.
Now finally at number 1 we have Ichigo Kurosaki, 4th anniversary Mugetsu version. As I mentioned before, this was incredibly difficult to place, as both him and Soifun are very different characters and both very very good characters. However, in my opinion, Mugetsu is just a little bit better. He currently has the highest SP in the game. He also has Frenzy and is equipped with really good strong attacks. Not only can they all inflict debilitating weakening, but they all have really good range, allowing him to clear the room a lot faster. I'm talking Manga Toshiro levels of speed since their attacks are actually pretty similar. Ichigo may have the edge though since he does have an extra sprinter. It's not Soifun level, but it does let him dodge specials easier and get through rooms faster. Plus in addition to his strong attack recharge link, he's also got a stamina recovery ability. He is the first and only character so far to have this as an ability, and it makes him a lot more durable, as well as a really good option for the Senkaimon Aizen build, since as long as he doesn't lose too much health, he can just go back to full health as soon as he enters a new area. This Ichigo is also completely immune to freezing and to top everything off, he's the first and only character so far to not be a tag team character and have two killers. And that is a really big deal, since it basically makes him super effective in any area that has a Hollow or a no affiliation enemy, not to mention Hollow or no affiliation bosses. This is especially useful in Senkaimon since it multiplies it so much. They really did pack a lot into this character. I don't blame them since he is the main character and they really want him to be special, and I'd say without a doubt they succeeded. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, hit like and subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for some more top 10 lists.